only see the very tip of the iceberg that's poking out of the water. That's the behaviors that you're going to see. Negative behaviors likely. Meltdowns, tantrums, bullying, teasing, taunting, sarcasm, slamming doors, rolling eyes, you know, I hate you, all of those things. Blaming other people for their problems. What holds up an iceberg is what's beneath the waterline. And I teach kids this all the time. So there's all this stuff underneath that's holding it up. If we look beneath the waterline, and that is our job as adults to look beneath that waterline and figure out what's going on, we'll see what's driving these behaviors that are the tip of the iceberg, sometimes overwhelming us and making us wish it wasn't happening. A lot of times it's gonna be anger, sadness, you know, feeling isolated, anxiety, worry, fears. Sometimes, you know, kids who carry around a lot of what ifs, what if I did this, what if I did that, what if this happens, what if that happens, stress, pressure, you know, all the pressure that they're under, just feeling like they're failing, all the negative emotions that they're stuffing all day long so that they can survive the school day. You know, what we know about kids is they come to school and they hold it together all day long, man. They are really good at holding it together at school, right? They're good. Their teachers, oh, they're lovely. What do you mean? There's no problem. This best student ever, right? And then they come home and they explode because they save it all for home because they've been surviving all day long. So, you know, when we look beneath the waterline and we ask ourselves, well, can any of these things be contributing to it? Like 9.5 times out of 10, yes, one of those things is contributing to that behavior that you're seeing at the top. So when we slow down and we do this for our kids, we can empathize with them. And we can say, ah, I get it. Okay, this is what's driving this behavior. Let's hit the reset and figure out how we can do things differently.